They are the largest Omaha-based credit card issuer, and they are working overtime tonight. Cybersecurity experts track down accounts affected by the Target Scrooge, the hacker who stole credit and debit card information from Target during the height of holiday shopping.
Secret Service is investigating how it happened and who's behind it. We do know when it happened, from November 27th to December 15th.
Everyone who shopped at Target in that time frame wants to know if they are victims of fraud. KETV News Watch 7's Dave Roberts is getting details for you. He joins us live.
Well, let's put this Target hack into perspective. On average, 100 million Americans have credit cards. Now, someone has 40 million of their credit card numbers, and some of those victims are right here in Omaha.
Right now, during the busy season, we're processing over 100,000 transactions a day.
Some of those purchases are victims of a cyber attack on Target stores nationwide. The retailer says 40 million accounts may have been affected between November 27th and December 15th.
The good news is that the industry's gotten a lot better at detecting it early.
First Bank Card President Stephen Yulee says cyber attacks are common. On average, hackers try to access First National Bank servers 1 million times a month.
We still get domestic attacks, of course, in the U.S., but we're getting more from Russia, from the Middle East, from China, and they're getting more and more sophisticated, too.
Jeff Weeks is the Chief Information Security Officer for First National Bank. He runs a building full of people and machines with one mission: beat the hackers.
A couple years ago, identity theft overtook the drug trade in the United States as the number one crime.
This time, the crime hit holiday shoppers using plastic at Target. It took 2 weeks for the store to notice.
Letting us know literally a couple of weeks after it started is a record time.
As First Bank Card compiles the accounts made vulnerable by the Target hackers, Yulee says the cyber criminals won't get much money because the jig is up.
We'll probably end up reissuing some of the credit cards and debit cards that we have on our customers that were part of this compromise.
But now here's a hopeful stat for all you credit card users. Only 0.1% of all credit card transactions are subject to fraud. Of course, the safest way still to pay is cash. Live at 72nd and Dodge, Dave Roberts, KETV, News Watch 7.